Who needs pyramid schemes or crooked money managers when you can lose money in the stock market all by yourself? Today, I talk about 10 mistakes to avoid when investing. First of all, number one, go with the herd. Well, if everyone else is buying it, why shouldn't I? Well, typically, when the average investor gets in on a particular stock or a particular run-up on the market, the game is pretty much over when that happens. The next one is put all your bets on one high-flying stock. Now, I know everybody has some tips, and a lot of times you get a coworker that has a tip on a stock. More times than not, that tip will end up costing you a lot of money. What about buying when the market is up, when everybody's piling into the market, expecting it to go higher? Well, your timing could be bad on this. What if you invested in December of 1999 at the absolute height of the technology bull market? And what about selling when the market is down? Again, this is another herd mentality. People get scared and everybody says, well, the market's going down, I'm going to get out. Usually when most people do that, the bottom is near. Next one, stay on the sidelines until the market calms down. Well, you want to know something? The market never calms down. It's always moving up and down and sideways. You need to invest for the long term based upon your goals and objectives and your risk tolerance. What about relying on pundits? You know, those television shows that tell you to buy this or sell that. Well, maybe if it's Warren Buffett, I'd think about doing it, but very few other people out there. Go with your gut. That's another thing people will do. Well, most times your gut is wrong. There's nothing like good old-fashioned research and sticking with a plan. React frequently to market volatility. You know, even traders, professional traders in the market, do poorly. In fact, most of them don't do very well when you actually look at the numbers. And finally, another thing that a lot of people say is buy and hold. Well, those days are gone too. What happens there is if the market does go up, your positions get riskier and riskier, although you weren't as risky when you started, but you're certainly riskier before the market goes down. Finally, it's good to take a long-term strategy, diversify, stick with your program, but rebalance periodically, and let the market work for you over a long period of time.